Don't feel proud because you've killed five folks. And then those that have killed more feel more proud and honored. You took somebody's life. You took somebody's life. It could have been you. And God spared you and gave you another chance. The heart of God is crying out to you. Come, bow before the Lord. Ask Him to forgive you for the sins you have committed against Him. You took that mother's daughter. That girl you shot in the head was that mother's daughter. That was her baby. That she believed that her baby was going to become something great in this life. And you shortened her life. For this, God is upset with you, young man. You need to ask His forgiveness. Young man that beat up on the women and think it's okay. Can you hear the cries of the Lord? Can you hear the Spirit of God saying, when will you come home? Some of you don't understand, this is true ministry. This is true ministry. True ministry. Because anybody that hear this and receive this, they'll truly be able to repent of their sins. I can feel some of you sitting there. This is the first time that you felt your conscience in years. You've been numb to the things that you do. I can feel you. I can feel you, sir. Your heartbeat is starting to beat really fast. So you can understand that's God Almighty touching you. You're feeling the conviction of the Lord inside your heart. You're feeling what you've never felt before. This evening is a service that God's saying to somebody, come home. You belong to God. You belong to God. You were created in his image to serve Him. God is saying, don't go down like that. Don't die for your homies and the thugs. Don't die for them. Why? You make the wrong move, you can guarantee one thing. They'll leave you. A lot of gangbangers, when they get shot and get paralyzed, their homies are nowhere to be found anymore. Nowhere to be found. And they're trying to maneuver their wheelchair by themselves. And they kill for the gangs. Well, there's one gang you can be a part of. That the leader of this gang, the scripture says, will in no wise cast you out, but He will receive you. The Spirit of the Lord is here for the people of God. This evening, come as you are. We're going to do an altar call. And everything that's not saved in this house, everyone that's not saved in this house, when we do this altar call, just like you've been bold on the streets, be bold enough. Be bold enough. Be bold enough to stand up and step to the front. Because I ain't going to ask everybody to close their eyes. Because nobody asked the people to close their eyes when you did dirt. You didn't care who saw you. Come to God with that same boldness. If you feel the bleeding heart of Jesus Christ this evening, if this sermon has reached you, if you feel God tugging at your heart this evening, don't wait for mama, daddy, don't wait for a friend, don't wait for a partner. If you believe this evening and you know you need Jesus this evening, I ask you right where you are, if you need Christ Jesus, stand to your feet right now without a moment's hesitation. If you need Christ Jesus in your heart. This is beautiful. This is beautiful because we got Christians standing. We got Christians who have already accepted Jesus, making it easy for the sinners. They're stepping forward. Everyone that's standing, that's the declaration you made, and this is what you're asking. Along with those that are sinners, support them, and you all come on to the front. Let's have a big altar call this evening.